Hi children, today I am going to start geography third lesson and the title of the lesson is atmosphere. Many a times we have learnt what is this atmosphere. The sphere of air or the sea of gases surrounding the earth is called atmosphere. And this word atmosphere is derived from Greek word atmos, which means vapor. It is about 1000 kilometers thick. The thickness of the atmosphere is 1000 kilometers. It is just like a very thin blanket surrounding the earth, but its thickness is 1000 kilometers. NASA, that means National Aeronautics and Space Administration, describes the size of the earth as a basketball. That means if we take the earth as a basketball, the atmosphere would be like a thin sheet of plastic wrapped around it. If we take the size of the earth as a basketball, the atmosphere would be like a thin sheet of plastic which we wrap around the earth. Now, composition of the atmosphere. Composition of atmosphere, it is composed of several gases like oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide, etc. Nitrogen, it constitutes 78% by volume, oxygen 21%, and other gases are in very small percentages, like carbon dioxide is 0.03%, and other gases like argon, neon, methane, etc. also are present in very less quantity. Water vapor accounts for about 0.4%. And other than these gases, the atmosphere also contains some fine dust particles. Other than these gases, there are some fine dust particles in the atmosphere, and these fine dust particles are called particulates. Where do these particles come from? These particulates may come through natural processes. Naturally, they come through natural processes like due to sandstorms over deserts or due to natural forest fires, and even from human activities like burning forests, burning fossil fuels, burning petroleum, and industrial emissions. What is the impact of these particulates on the atmosphere? They affect the climate also, and they affect the conditions of the human beings also. They can change the atmospheric conditions that are beneficial to life on earth. You might have enjoyed the bright orange color of the sunrise and or sunset. Many a times you might have enjoyed the bright orange color of the sunrise or sunset. Did you enjoy it? And this bright orange color of the sun is caused due to these particulates only. And the rainfall, the hailstones which the children enjoy most, are also made possible due to these particulates only. Not only these benefits, particulates can also cause some problems by changing the pattern of temperature and rainfall. Due to these particulates in the atmosphere, the pattern of temperature and rainfall also may be affected. For example, they can cause breathing problems for human beings. Sometimes these particulates settle on leaves and make it very difficult for the plants to breathe. That means they cause breathing problems in human beings and also in the plants. And thus, they cause hindrance to the process of photosynthesis, through which the plants make their food. As you know, all the plants make their food through photosynthesis. And sometimes these particulates, they settle on the leaves and they cause hindrance to the process of photosynthesis. Now, the structure of the atmosphere. Now let us learn about the structure of the atmosphere. On the basis of chemical composition, the atmosphere is broadly divided into two layers, homosphere and heterosphere. The two broad layers are homosphere and heterosphere. Homosphere, as the name indicates, there is uniformity in the composition of gases in this layer of the atmosphere. This homosphere extends up to a height of 90 kilometers, and you can see in the picture it consists of three layers: troposphere, stratosphere, and mesosphere. And as I told you just now, this layer has uniformity in composition of gases like nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, etc. Heterosphere, this is a layer above 90 kilometers of the atmosphere, that means above the homosphere. It has two layers called thermosphere and exosphere. And now let us study about the layers of homosphere. The first and the foremost layer of the atmosphere is troposphere. and it is the densest layer of the atmosphere. Its average height is 13 kilometers and roughly it extends up to a height of 8 kilometers near the poles and 18 kilometers at the equator. So total comes 8 kilometers near the poles and 18 kilometers at the equator. 18 plus 8, 26. So average comes to 13. That is why its average height is 13 kilometers and roughly it extends up to a height of 8 kilometers near the poles and 18 kilometers at the equator. This troposphere is greatest at the equator. Now, all the weather phenomena like evaporation, condensation, precipitation, they take place in this layer only. All the weather changes, evaporation, condensation, precipitation, all these take place in this layer only. And it contains about 75% of the total gaseous mass of the atmosphere. And temperature in this layer decreases as the altitude increases. And this already we know, and this is known as normal lapse rate. As we move to higher altitudes, temperature decreases in the troposphere, and this is known as normal lapse rate. And the second layer is stratosphere. The layer above the troposphere is stratosphere. It extends up to a height of 50 kilometers and it is almost free from clouds. And that is why this layer is ideal for flying jet aircrafts. Jet aircrafts or aeroplanes, they fly in this layer only because this layer is free from clouds. It contains ozone layer, that is the importance of this layer. It contains ozone layer, and in this layer, temperature decreases with an increase in altitude. Remember, in troposphere, the temperature decreases with increase in the altitude. And in this stratosphere, the temperature increases with an increase in the altitude. Now, the third layer is mesosphere. The layer above the stratosphere is mesosphere. It extends up to a height of 80 kilometers. And in this layer, meteorites burn up. When they enter from the space into the Earth's surface, they burn up in this mesosphere. And in this layer, again, the temperature starts decreasing with an increase in the altitude. Just like in troposphere, again, the temperature decreases with an increase in the altitude. First troposphere, the temperature decreases with an increase in the altitude. Stratosphere, the temperature increases with an increase in the altitude. And again, mesosphere, the temperature decreases with an increase in the altitude. Now, the fourth one is thermosphere. Thermosphere, it extends up to a height of 400 kilometers. And it contains electrically charged particles called ions. That is the importance of this layer. It contains electrically charged particles called ions, and because of these ions only, it is also known as ionosphere. And in this layer, radio waves are reflected back to the Earth's surface. The sound waves, when they are transmitted from the Earth towards atmosphere, then these radio waves are reflected back to the Earth's surface by these ions only, and because of this only, we are able to listen to the radio programs. And in this layer, temperature increases rapidly with increase in altitude. Again, in this last layer, thermosphere, the temperature rapidly increases with an increase in the altitude. Remember, in all the four layers, the temperature decreases or increases alternatively. Troposphere, the temperature decreases. Next, stratosphere, temperature increases with an increase in the altitude. Mesosphere decreases, and thermosphere, it rapidly increases with an increase in the altitude. And the outermost layer and uppermost layer of the atmosphere is exosphere. But about this layer, nothing much is known. Very little is known about this layer. We know only that it is the uppermost layer of the atmosphere. Now the next topic is atmospheric pressure. What is this atmospheric pressure? The weight of the atmosphere exerts pressure on the Earth's surface. That means, atmospheric pressure means the weight of column of air at any given point on the surface of the Earth. Why this air exerts pressure on the Earth's surface? Because it consists of many molecules, tiny molecules. And these molecules, they push each other. Continuously, they keep on pushing each other. And in this, that attempt, whatever object comes on their way, they push that object also. And this only we are calling as pressure. They exert pressure on the earth's surface or on any object which comes on their way. So the weight of the atmosphere exerts pressure on the earth's surface, and thus atmospheric pressure means the weight of column of air at any given point on the surface of the earth. And it is also known as barometric pressure because the instrument which is used to measure atmospheric pressure is barometer. So this pressure is also called as barometric pressure. The normal atmospheric pressure is equivalent to 760 millimeters or 1013.2 millibars. It is measured in millibars. And atmospheric pressure decreases with an increase in the altitude. Temperature and atmospheric pressure are inversely proportional. Already we know that as the altitude increases, atmospheric pressure decreases. Temperature and atmospheric pressure, they are inversely proportional. That means if one increases, the other decreases. If temperature decreases, the atmospheric pressure increases, and vice versa. That means if temperature increases, the atmospheric pressure decreases. Like that, both are inversely proportional. And if humidity is higher, what is the relationship between humidity and atmospheric pressure? If humidity is higher, the pressure will be less, and vice versa. That means if humidity is higher, pressure will be less, and if humidity is less, the pressure will be more. And the mean sea level pressure generally varies from 900 MB to 1030 MB. The general mean sea level pressure is 900 MB to 1030 MB. And so far, the world's highest sea level pressure has been recorded in Agata, Siberia. And it is equal to 1083.3 MB. It is the highest sea level pressure so far recorded in the world, and it was recorded on December 31st, 1968. And the lowest sea level pressure was observed in the eye of typhoon tip west of Mariana Islands. On October 12th, 1979, it was observed, and it was equal to 870 MB. MB means millibars. Now see the pressure belts. Pressure belts, there are 7 pressure belts on the earth's surface. You can see in the diagram here. The one is in and around the equator, equatorial low pressure belt. It extends on both sides. In the northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere also it extends. It is only one belt, equatorial low pressure belt. And this equatorial low pressure belt is called as doldrums or ITCZ, that means intertropical convergence zone. This is low pressure. And you can see to the north of equatorial low pressure belt, there is subtropical high pressure belt in northern hemisphere, and in the same way subtropical high pressure belt in the southern hemisphere. So there are 2 subtropical high pressure belts. Equatorial low pressure belt is 1, subtropical high pressure belts are 2. And further to the north of this subtropical high pressure belt in the northern hemisphere, there is subpolar low pressure belt. Likewise, in the southern hemisphere also there is another subpolar low pressure belt. That means in both northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere also subpolar low pressure belts are there. You can see these are alternative. First equatorial low pressure belt, then high pressure belt, subtropical high pressure belt, then again low pressure belt, subpolar low pressure belt. And finally, near the poles, near North Pole, it is polar high pressure belt, and near the South Pole, it is polar high pressure belt again. So there are in total 7 pressure belts on the earth's surface. Now, wind always moves from high pressure areas to low pressure areas. That already we know. Wherever there is high pressure, from those areas, the wind moves to the low pressure areas. And if it moves at a slow pace, slowly if the wind moves, and we feel comfortable, we call it as cool breeze. You might have heard saying, cool breeze is blowing today. We feel very comfortable then. So that is called as breeze. If the wind moves at a slow pace and we feel comfortable, it is called as breeze. And if the wind comes in a short and fast burst, for a short time like a fast burst if it comes, it is called gust, G-U-S-T, gust. And if it moves very fast and blows things around it, it is called as storm. That already we know. It blows away all the things which come on their way, on its way. The low pressure area near the equator is called doldrums or ITCZ. ITCZ means intertropical convergence zone. Now the next topic is Coriolis effect. What is this Coriolis effect? See the diagram once. Both in northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere also there is Coriolis effect. What is this Coriolis effect? The apparent force generated by the Earth's rotation is called Coriolis effect. That means all the moving objects, they generate some force. And because the Earth is also rotating continuously, from west to east it rotates, and during this rotation process only, it generates some force, and that force is called as Coriolis effect. The apparent force generated by the Earth's rotation is called Coriolis effect, and it has zero effect near the equator. This Coriolis effect is zero near the equator and maximum effect at the poles. The Coriolis effect is maximum at the poles and it is zero near the equator. Because at the equator the Earth is bulgy, so it is zero. And it is maximum at the poles because they are just points, poles, North Pole and South Pole. And due to this Coriolis, now let us see what is the effect of this Coriolis effect. Due to this Coriolis effect, winds in the northern hemisphere are deflected towards right, that is east. And in the southern hemisphere, winds are deflected towards left, that is west. That means if the winds are blowing in east direction, suppose the winds are blowing in southeast direction in the southern hemisphere, and if they cross the equator, they will reach the northern hemisphere. Immediately they will change their direction to southwest. East will change into west. That is to say that due to this Coriolis effect, winds in the northern hemisphere are deflected towards right, and in the southern hemisphere winds are deflected towards left. And I will give you an example how this Coriolis effect affects the climate of India. Southeast monsoons, they cross the equator, and when they cross the equator, they are entering into northern hemisphere. Immediately they change their direction and they become southwest monsoons, and it is because of southwest monsoons that the whole country gets rainfall. India gets rainfall through southwest monsoons, and because of this Coriolis effect only we are getting southwest monsoons. Now the classification of winds. Depending upon the wind speed and their characteristic features, or the direction in which they are moving and the way they occur, winds are classified into three types. So mainly winds are classified into three types, and they are planetary winds, seasonal winds and local winds. Now let us see what are these planetary winds. Planetary winds means the winds which blow in a definite direction throughout the year from high pressure to low pressure areas. They are governed by the pressure belts, and such winds are called planetary winds. Governed by the pressure belts, winds moving from high pressure to low pressure throughout the year in a definite direction are called planetary winds. Seasonal winds, these are also called as periodic winds, and only in a particular region or in a particular season they blow. That is why they are called as seasonal winds or periodic winds. Local winds, depending on the differences in temperature and atmospheric pressure of a place, these local winds blow. Now we will discuss about these winds in detail in our next class. As of now I am giving you homework. Read the part of the lesson completed, underlining all the important points with pencil, and learn and write 1 mark and 2 mark questions from this part of the lesson without seeing in your notebook. Because it is geography, from front part you write these question answers. Draw the diagrams of pressure belts and planetary winds in the notebook.